Howdy all and welcome to Lex Lives. I think it's time we play a little Minecraft. Alright. Man, it's been a day, let me tell ya. It's been a long couple of days at this point, honestly. All involving my computer. It has been driving me bonkers. So, I've bought some new parts for the beast, and you know, I was pretty excited to get them put in there. Ordered some more RAM so things would run better, and I definitely can tell the difference with the extra amount of RAM. And bought some different hard drive, and you know, spent the day moving things around and stuff like that. And so that was my entire afternoon. On Wednesday of this week, which had been yesterday. And so, and then today, I hadn't recorded on it yet, right? And so that's the whole reason I bought all this stuff, right? Well, I guess not the whole reason, but one of the big reasons is because I wanted to, did you see that Pigman sneak through there? I wanted to get a new hard drive to record onto and pull it off of my storage where I've been putting it, the recordings sessions, and then that way I could record onto a separate drive altogether and see how that works. And then, you know, there's some other issues, like I'm sure I've complained about running out of memory on my computer. I had 12 gigabytes, and so the motherboard supports 24 gigabytes, but I only had 12 because the motherboard supports a speed of RAM that's expensive, and not DDR4 either. It's DDR3, but it's expensive DDR3. I don't know why it's so expensive, just a step down, which the motherboard also supports. I forgot what I was doing here. I came to get some dark oak. And just a step down from its max speed, just slightly less, like 144 megahertz, I guess. It supports 1866 is what I bought. It supports 2000, but I bought 1866, which was like half the price. It was like $350, I think, for 24 gigabytes of 2000, and it was $150 for 24 gigabytes of, well, that's less than half, right? So it's $200 cheaper. And so since it's $200 cheaper, I went ahead and ordered a 500 gigabyte SSD for my recording drive. And yeah, I can really tell the difference too. This everything seems to work way better with the new RAM. And yeah, there's still some bugs with it. I tried something new this time I have never done before. Usually when I get a new hard drive, especially for the operating system, like, I didn't get a new one for the operating system, but we'll talk about that in a second. Well, I guess we should talk about it before we talk about this other thing. That would make sense. Let's do the story in order, right? So, after I bought the RAM, Windows wanted to update, and so I told it to go ahead and update. And then Windows told me there was enough room on the hard drive to update. Now, I just cleaned off whatever off the hard drive, and it had the other day 5 gigabytes of free space on it. I know that doesn't sound like a lot, but it's a 60 gigabyte hard drive. I mean, how big is an operating system? And so then it's telling me there's no room, and so I'm like, well, this is dumb. So I I can't find anything to clean off. It just keeps getting bigger and bigger. Every time you update Windows, the amount of space that Windows takes is just bigger and bigger. And it's not the updates that are doing it. It's the stupid, this version is going to be saved in case it isn't compatible. But the problem is that the thing that's making it not compatible for me is that you're using up all my hard drive space with your other versions of Windows. Or not versions of Windows, but versions of the files. So system files are kept in like triplicate, basically. And so because it's keeping all these versions of the system files, it might not work. We might need to revert back from our patch. And so obviously we gotta keep the version that our patch is, the version that's currently running, and the old version that used to be on there. And then when you update, well, now you've got the new version, the version that's running, the version before that, and then the original version, right? And then you update again, it's got the new update, the old update, the update before that, and the original version, plus the version that's currently being used. And so it just grows like that, right? And I mean, how many hundreds of times has Windows updated since I started using Windows 7 6 years ago? So we're talking a lot of space this operating system's taken. And then on top of that, you got all your stupid programs that are like, oh yeah, you can install me wherever you want, but I'm gonna save every single thing that happens onto a different drive. Because why would my saved games and reports from my game go on the drive where I installed the game? Obviously, if it's stored on the D drive, if the game itself is installed on the D drive, obviously all the other files involving that game need to be stored on the C drive. So yeah, it ran out of room. NVIDIA was a culprit too. NVIDIA kind of does the same thing. They keep previous versions of the drivers that you installed. And so when I cleaned off NVIDIA and as much of old Windows files as it would let me, I had cleaned out a huge chunk the other, like 6 gigabytes or 7.9 gigabytes or something like that of stuff that I deleted off my hard drive, and now it's back down to 1.8. And Windows is telling me there's not enough room in 1.8 gigabytes to do what it wants. So I'm like, all right, I'm gonna order a new hard drive. That's my plan. I had three, so I'm gonna order a fourth one, and I'm gonna get one for recording, which I did. And so then with my new recording drive, what I can do is I can shuffle things around. And so that's what I did. That was my Wednesday afternoon. I shuffled stuff. I used a cloning program. First I moved my game hard drive content onto my game slash recording hard drive. It's also my storage hard drive for anything that I just want to keep. So I moved that hard drive, because it was a 120 gigabyte hard drive, onto my 2 terabyte, or it was a 120 SSD onto my 2 terabyte hard drive. With that free, I used a cloning program, which I don't normally use, to clone my operating system drive, which is 60 gigabytes, onto the 120, giving me a 120 operating system drive that's an SSD, all by itself. And then I used the 60 to hold my modded Minecraft. That's all that's on there right now. And I kept my Steam account, which used to be on the 120 SSD, on my 2 terabyte, and now all my recordings go onto the 500 gigabyte SSD, because it's a lot faster and a lot easier to record to. A lot of fitzing around and switching stuff in and out, and so that was my Wednesday afternoon. Moving that many files, we're talking hundreds of gigabytes of files I moved around. That takes about an hour and a half. I probably was moving files and deleting stuff, and it only took like 30 minutes to get the programs in. But then once we got past that, and I was ready to boot onto my new hard drive. Apparently the clone program didn't clone everything correctly. And so then I had to find my Windows. Oh no, that was an accident. I didn't mean to do it. I didn't mean to do it. I just saw you there and I thought enemy. It was an accident. I'm sorry. Are you guys still angry? I don't think there's anybody that can see me, so maybe they're not angry now. No, I'm pretty sure that guy over there looks like he's still angry. I better go out and kill him, just get rid of him. That way when I forget, they don't come back and haunt me. But I can't get through over here, right? No. It's gotta be down over here. Oh, there we go. I was gonna say there's no way to get over to you guys, but I found it. I found it, and you're not even over here. Was I hallucinating the pig feet? Oh, you guys aren't aggro. Alright. Never mind, everybody's friendly now. So, you know, I had to go through the whole hassle of finding my Windows disk, repairing my installation, and then once I got into Windows, then it wouldn't let me watch Netflix, and so I've been dealing with little glitches like that now, because, like, the Netflix thing, DRM errors. My DRM wasn't correct on my computer. I'd hunt down that file and delete it before it'd work. And the worst one of all, though, that I've been experiencing is sound settings. It will not use my sound settings. I don't even understand, but when it first got installed, it refused to use my headset. It finally has agreed to just use my headset, but I had to disable my television as a sound source. My video card, of course, is hooked up to my televisions with HDMI cable, and so it counts the speakers on the television as one of the sound outputs. Unfortunately, also thinks that they're an input in certain instances. So that's not really working out all that well for me. And so I've been fighting with that all day. And I've honestly been recording for probably close to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, I'm probably approaching 5 hours of recording today, and I've recorded an hour and 15 minutes of actual footage that I could use. And whether or not what I'm doing right now is even usable, I have no idea. It's dumb. It's really dumb. It's crazy. It's downright crazy. I'm sitting here and whoops, and I've got two screens that I use. And so the second screen has got my recording software on it, and I'm looking right at it on the other game I was playing, and I pushed the record button. I made sure all the settings for sound and video and all that were correct. I pushed the record button, and I watched it change my sound settings. They were in there until I hit the record button, and then it changed them. It flat out changed my settings. I watched them switch, and they didn't switch to something like normal. No, they switched to television. In fact, the last game I just finished recording was my fourth attempt at recording because it just kept switching the sound settings. And then I switched them back after I started the game. So I start the game, I s check the sound settings, they look right. I press record and they shift. Right? That's what I'm looking at here. And so then I'm like, okay, well that's not right. And so I shift them back to what I need. And then I record the episode. Like I stop recording, I switch the sound settings back. I press the record button. I check them. They're right. And then I finish recording and I check the settings and they're still the same thing I needed them to be. And then I check the footage and the footage says it's recorded two sets of game sound and not my microphone. Two sets of game sound and not my microphone. There is no sound going into my microphone except me talking or, whatever noise happens in the room. But, seriously, game or recording software, I guess. What are you doing? You drive. So I'm looking right at it right now, and it is listing my microphone. So I'm hoping this is recording correctly. I recorded three episodes of 7 Days to Die. I recorded two episodes of Kingdoms of Amalur, and I recorded four episodes of Hand of Fate, trying to get a Hand of Fate where the sound settings would work. Is that yeah, all right. Seriously, it was terrible. And then, while I'm fiddling around with all that, trying to figure out what's going wrong, I was on my system page for some reason. Why was I on my system page? I don't know, but I noticed that my computer said 24 gigabytes installed, 16 gigabytes in use. I'm like, oh no, now what's going on, you stupid thing? And so I wasn't aware that Windows is dumb. I don't understand the limitations on memory. Okay, I understand the difference between 32 and 64 and how that affects memory, right? This is something I know. It's part of my job. I know this. I don't remember, however, all the minute differences between the 18,000 versions of Windows. And so I had forgotten that Windows 7 Home Premium does not allow you to use more than 16 gigabytes of memory. And I have Windows Home Premium installed. And so I'm like, are you kidding me? I have got 24 gigabytes of RAM, and you're telling me I can't use 8 of it because you're stupid. So yeah, that was one of the things I dealt with while I was in there, trying to figure out what's wrong with my sound. Still not sure what's wrong with my sound. Like I said, it just swapped over on me for no reason. I keep switching it back. It keeps switching back. It's making me angry. And then on top of that, I gotta go to work. I gotta work early tomorrow. So, here I thought I was gonna have a nice, easy afternoon. Got my new software to play, or my new hardware to play with. Get things nice and recorded, and with all this extra RAM and the faster hard drive, then my rendering should go faster. Which means I'll spend less time. I'm gonna go swimming this afternoon. I'm gonna mow some lawn, I have so much time now because of the new hardware. I'll be able to run multiple things. Heck no, I've been doing nothing but changing settings and fighting with it, trying to get what I need out of it. All right, I need some. I don't even know what that is. Is that brown stained clay? I honestly don't know what I shoved in here. Oh, it's not going to tell me until I pick it up. What are you? You are gray stained clay. Okay. So gray is bones and squid. So I'm going to have to go hunt some squid, I'm sure. So let's head out and find some squid here. But yeah, the windows, I'm like, that's just dumb. It is an artificial thing that's been placed in there by Windows to stop my computer from being able to use. I swear that I thought it was 64. I thought it was 64 was the limit on Windows Home Premium. Apparently it's 16 though. In fact, it's so arbitrary. Windows Home Premium is 16 gigabytes is the limit. Windows Home Professional is 192 gigabytes. And then bigger versions, of course, support way more. So how artificial is it that Windows Home Premium is 16? It's bizarre. So I'm looking on the system page, and of course it's got like upgrade anytime, and click here to upgrade your version of Windows to a better version. And I'm like, all right. So I clicked on it, and it's like $85 to upgrade to Windows Home or Windows Professional, Windows 7 Professional. I'm like, there ain't no way I'm paying $85 for this. I'm like, I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. Where I work has Windows 7 professional codes, which I am allowed to use on my home system. So I'm just gonna go grab one of the free ones from work, and because I'm not paying $85 just so I can use 8 gigabytes more of RAM. If it had been like $25 or $30, I'd have probably done it, but no. I actually went to work and got a code. And the IT guy's like, "Oh yeah, here you go." I'm like, "Awesome." And so input my code, Windows updates. Didn't take it very long. And then once it was updated, I'm on Windows 7 Professional. I can access my full 24 gigabytes of RAM. And now, if I can just get my sound settings to stop switching around on me. I also fiddling with my video settings as well. I've been trying this new codec, and I don't quite like the way it looks compared to my old codec. But I noticed that some of the settings I had were different than the suggested settings that everybody else is using. So maybe it'll make a difference. I don't know. We'll have to see. I do know some other things happened. Like, this is bizarre to me. All right, this is a weird one. So I realize it's glitchy because I cloned my operating system drive onto this other drive, and whatever happened, things don't quite work right. Fine, whatever. I mean, Windows loads and most of my big software runs fine. It's just little things like trying to run Netflix and having Silverlight tell me that my DRM management is incorrect, and stuff like that. And so the one of the weird things that occurred was all right. One of the weird things that happened was, yeah, my brain is totally fizzling down here. My timer. I use a timer when I record, so I know how long I've been recording. Oh yeah, I should probably get some hardened clay, huh? Hardened clay is in this chest here. I'm still trying to figure out where I want to put things, so. Not everything has made it into the system yet. In fact, I don't know if the system's You know, I kind of want these to be inset. I'm going to knock these off here. I'm going to do them from this side. I think they look better. Like that. Oh yeah, I see you've finished all of that, and that's not blinking, so that means that everything should be in the system. I had some issues with this filling up, so I moved my stone down one chest, and I had issues with this filling up. This was dirt and netherrack, now it's just dirt. Hardened clay is over here. Netherrack got bumped over here to its own chest. Sand and clay made it into this chest. Oh no, sand's over here. Why isn't sand over here? How did you get over here, sand? I guess the next chest would have been this chest, and I put stone in there. So things are coming along with this, and it'll be awesome once I finish getting the item frames on there, so I know what's in each chest without having to open it up. My timer, I use a timer when I record, so I know where I'm at. It's just on my screen. It's not anything special. And every time I started it at the beginning of the day, the first instance of opening that timer would crash. And even weirder, I couldn't close it. Like, it would say not responding, and you couldn't use it. And I couldn't go into, whatchamacallit, my brain's drawn a blank here. You know, the thing where you hit Control-Alt-Delete, and you open the window so that you can close programs, system, whatever it is. I can't believe I can't remember what that's called. I was going into that today, and it wouldn't let me close in there. I couldn't click on the process and tell the process to close. So I thought maybe I had a virus, and so I rebooted. Well, I had to shut my computer down because it wouldn't close that timer that was frozen and wouldn't let me in there to do anything. And so I'm like, well, this isn't good at all. And so that's dumb. I'm gonna need those. So let's go with andesite here. Andesite's not going to get me up high enough to reach anything, though, I don't think. Oh, it might. And, so every time it froze, I'm like, this is just totally bizarre. And so I, reboot in safe mode, I run Malwarebytes and my antivirus and my registry cleaner and CC cleaner. Don't really find anything at all, but I think the registry cleaner, or maybe CC cleaner, one of those two, actually seems to fix most of my issues. I just assume it's because the operating system was cloned. Oh, I used, SFC scan now and, all that kind of stuff. Trying to make sure everything's correct. Now that I'm on professional, I got my full 24 gigabytes going, and, it's all pretty smooth at the moment. That's quite a big jump up for my computer here from 12 gig of RAM to 24 gig of RAM, and then moving from the one hard drive holding a bunch of stuff to just the SSD being used for recording, and the operating system got more room, and I was able to run some upgrades that it was refusing to do. But that's my new warehouse right there. I'm not sure if it needs some windows on it or what, but it definitely needs me to remove this grass. And this. You don't match, man. Alright, let's see. Dirt, get in there. Go get sorted. You give me some cobblestone here to fill this in with. Whoops, gold bar. So next episode of this should be back on the house. I can't promise anything, but it should be back on the house. Maybe, I don't know. We'll see. I still need to put a roof on this thing and a back wall for that matter and get some torches made so I can torch up the inside a little bit here. Maybe glowstone. Maybe I should bring in some glowstone. But yeah. All right. Well, with that, click like if you like, subscribe, be sure and catch the next one. And I'll talk to you later. We'll be right back.